while Demetrious Johnson was dominating the UFC, Adriano Moraes was dominating one championship. He was King of the East, Demetrious is King of the West, and now the two kings collide to decide who is truly the champ.
It's all about like one championship against UFC. If I win DJ, one championship has created the best athlete in the world.
I could have argued for a title shot, but it's always good to have athletes work for the belt.
He has everything already. When he tried to cross my way, man, he's gonna fail.
I go out there and I blow the bricks off Adriano Moraes.
They bound out of their corner. The long legs, the long arms on the champion, Adriano Moraes. Outside leg kick early here from Demetrious Johnson. Switching stance between southpaw and orthodox here, Demetrious. Just parries away the high kick. Downstairs goes Moraes.
Adriano wants to use his striking. He wants to keep this match on the feet, start touching up DJ and utilize that length advantage that he's got. He says if DJ takes him down, he's actually going to be doing him a favor because he wants to test those submission skills of DJ.
Outside leg kick just dropped it below the lead knee there, did Adriano. Both in center circle. Pouring with that range-finding lead hand, Adriano Moraes.
DJ just switched leads, now he switched back again.
I like it when he's utilizing that low leg kick though on DJ from Adriano every time DJ goes to orthodox. And he's spinning him around with it.
Could be see DJ get back to center circle, nicely done. A quick shuffle in there from the American. Adriano's been trying to press him to the outside. High kick there, forearms guard from Demetrious. Adriano circles off clockwise. First 1.5 minutes down of our world title match.
Good lateral movement from Moraes.
Yeah, I was about to say, I like the way that Adriano's using his footwork here. He's making it very difficult. He's using that range, making it difficult for DJ to actually get in and not allowing himself to get trapped in the quote-unquote corner of the circle.
Because that's what DJ does. He likes to put your back up against the wall and start going to work on you. And Moraes is not allowing that to happen.
Yeah.
The corner of Adriano saying stay fluid inside the circle as he goes clockwise once more, the champion. Hooked to a cross there, gut-munching knee from Demetrious Johnson. Tie clinch and a high knee from DJ. Short knee on the inside. Little peppering palm heel strike there, Muay Thai clinch.
DJ's got a very good clinch. He also utilizes the knees well. It's a very intelligent idea for Moraes to try to close the distance and press DJ up against the wall when he starts to do that, so DJ can't get his hips into those knees.
Haven't seen a lot of offense so far from Adriano. Been using a lot of the circle to move Johnson around, make Demetrious come to him, and Demetrious missing with those punches. Body kick. Just bludgeoned that into the body of Demetrious Johnson. The crack reverberated around this massive stadium. And now Mikinho, the champion, on his back and looking to throw those legs up.
You can see Adriano's trying to lace up those legs, possibly going to a heel hook submission right here. He traps the leg in Ashigarami. Now he's got an exposed heel hook on the outside. Let's see if he starts to threaten it. DJ needs to create that space. He needs to get exactly what he needs to do. Good job to fall into the guard, but Adriano was immediately jumping on top.
What a start to this flyweight world championship match. Where does Demetrious Johnson go from here, Dragon?
Well, you can see Adriano push down the left leg of Demetrious Johnson to end up in half guard. Now he wraps that arm around the head and he's gonna try to just smush his shoulder into the chin of DJ to create that pressure.
Is DJ in any danger here whatsoever, Dragon?
He's flat on his back. He has to get off of his flat of his back. He's got to try to get up onto his left side and get an underhook on his right arm. He can also wall walk here, but he's trying to do with his legs up on the side of the circle wall.
In the stand-up, it was Demetrious Johnson who was going forward on the front foot, launching the offense on the ground. It's been in favor of Adriano Moraes. Once again, this bout will be judged in its entirety and not round by round. Inside the closed guard now of DJ with under 1 minute to go.
I think one thing you need to take into account here with Adriano on top of DJ is possibly the weight differential here, how much heavier he is. And DJ probably doesn't want to put in a lot of effort or waste a lot of energy pushing Adriano off the top of him.
One foot on hips here from Demetrious. Adriano looks to pass on the left side.
30 seconds left in the first round.
Good little right hand there from Adriano. Locked down, pinned down the left arm of the champion. Good elbow off the back there from Demetrious Johnson. Lots of instructions coming from the corner of Adriano, not so much from the corner of DJ.
You can see DJ is able to strike off his back, but I like the way Adriano is able to land strikes in that ground and pound situations.
An intriguing opening round to our world title contest. They go to the towels, looking very composed, very relaxed. The champion, Adriano Moraes. Certainly a lot to pick apart in the opening 5 minutes.
Yeah, that was a good round for Adriano. You could see the first maybe 3 minutes or so, he was just moving around the circle, warming up, getting nice and light, not really taking shots, but not really throwing a lot of shots. He did land some kicks here and there, but it was mostly DJ pressing forward. But then in those last 2 minutes, he was able to get on top, land a little bit of ground and pound, and just show that superior size that he's going to have in this matchup, Rich.
Demetrious Johnson always has that amazing poker face. You can never read what DJ is thinking, what's coming up. And certainly, it has been a lot to offer for the challenger in the opening 5 minutes as we get set to rock and roll into the second round. Olivia Costa to get us underway. Round two, set for five. Ace Rich Franklin, how did you see the first 5 minutes?
Yeah, I have Adriano just edging it out after at the five-minute mark of this match. He was, I'm not sure if I would have awarded DJ the takedown necessarily, but ultimately Adriano was able to score that reversal and then spend a lot of time on top.
Both men just testing with the hands, dipping their toes in the water now with the leg kicks. You sense a little bit more mustard behind both of them here in the second round. Both have tried to press each other to the outside. Both have managed to come back to establish themselves in the center of the circle. Long reaching jab there from DJ. No right hand for company. Moraes was constantly drifting to his left in the opening round. Good glancing right hand there from Demetrious Johnson.
But Adriano started to move away. As soon as that right hand landed, you could immediately see him circle away, stay out of danger, and not take any other shots. I do like the way Moraes is utilizing the kicks, especially with that reach advantage that he's going to have. It's going to be even longer with the legs. And he said he spent a lot of time working on his Taekwondo and his karate-style kicks.
Taekwondo, a national martial art of Korea, predominantly a kicking martial art, also an Olympic sport. Head movement here from Demetrious Johnson. Just gets out of the way. He thought a right hand was coming. It was a high left round kick, though, from Adriano. Again, plenty of Portuguese language instructions coming from the corner of Adriano Moraes.
I love that when DJ switches stances, there's almost no tell. There's no difference between him going southpaw and orthodox. He's like the same version, just a completely different side of him. I love it.
And he does an amazing job in the transition as well. Like, normally that's when you can catch a fighter, is when he's moving from one stance to the next.
Just tipping down there momentarily, seeing if he can test those waters. Demetrious Johnson. Long-reaching jab there from the champion, Moraes. Circles off clockwise again. Staying out of reach of the hands of Demetrious. Almost walked into a high knee there, did DJ. He got caught by Moraes. Top position now for the champion. Throws a knee to the jaw. DJ's hurt. It's good night, Irene! Adriano Moraes defeats Demetrious Johnson. If you know, you know. If you didn't, you know now. It's not a shock to Adriano. It's not a shock to those that have seen him dominate one championship over the last few years. He did as he prophesied yesterday. He finishes the great Demetrious Johnson.
In two rounds, Michael Cervello. I've been watching him his entire career, and I'm shocked. He just shocked the world, Michael.
You know, Adriano did a great job there of using his range, because what he was doing is creating a situation where Demetrious had to overcommit on some of these strikes, and that's what ended up setting up that knee that he caught him with.
It started with the left hand, though. I think it was the punch that caught him, stumbled DJ, and then he was able to jump all over him. Take a look at it again. Look at this. Misses barely with the jumping knee there. You can see DJ starts to close that distance, but boom, it was that right uppercut that touched DJ. DJ goes down, and it's this knee. Bingo, right there. That puts the GOAT on his back.
Well, Adriano said at yesterday's press conference, while Demetrious was dominating UFC, I was dominating one championship. East met West tonight, and it was indeed Adriano Moraes who prevailed in hefty fashion. Let's go to Dom Lau to make it all official. Amazing scenes of jubilation here for Adriano Moraes. But you know what? He had the confidence. This is no surprise to Adriano. He said he would do this exact same thing. He didn't say whether he'd specifically submit or knock out Demetrious Johnson. He just said, I will stop Demetrious Johnson. I'll probably do it inside of three rounds.
He had been adamant talking about how he's been able to study DJ for the last year and a half since he signed with ONE Championship. And that's evident right there.
What an amazing moment. What an amazing champion. He has just defeated the man known as the greatest of all time, and he has done so in epic fashion. No controversy, not left in the hands of the judges. It was a fantastic performance. And once he got his gusto, he finished the job. Incredible scenes inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, where Adriano Moraes has defeated Demetrious Johnson. Let's go to Dom Lau.
This match was presented to you by Hexbox. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sitchotong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 24 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout and still ONE Flyweight World Champion, Adriano.